If you are looking to create a business logo, then look no further. Canva has just about every kind of template that you could think of. So if you want a simple and easy business logo that just needs a little bit of modification, then you better watch this video. What's going on, guys? If this is your first time to my channel, then my name is Tamil, and on this channel, I create videos teaching entrepreneurs how to start and grow their online business with tech videos. So if you want to learn anything about this kind of stuff, then hit the subscribe button and that little bell notification so that you get notified when I drop new videos on this channel. All right, now let's get started. The first thing that you want to do if you are already logged into Canva is you want to go up to the top of the search and you want to type in logo. And once you type in logo, you will come to this page right here that is filled with tons of business logos that you can choose from, that you can customize and make it to fit your brand and your liking. So these are a lot of different logos, guys, that you can use. And it's all about modifying and changing things around to fit exactly what you like. I am looking for a template to show you guys how you can create a simple and easy business logo. So I think I see one right here. One of the things that you will find if you already have Canva is you will find some that have that little crown in the corner. Well, that crown is for people that have already upgraded to the Canva Pro account. If you have a Canva Pro account, then you're already going to get these for free. But if you are just using the free account, then you want to use the logos that do not have anything that show up. If it doesn't have anything that shows up in the corner, then those are the free ones. And usually you can just go ahead and pick from those. So I'm going to choose this logo to work with today. So here I am inside of this logo design. And one of the things that I want to show you guys is how you can just modify a simple, you know, business logo just like this. Now, one of the things that I want to tell you is that if you plan on using this logo for something other than just, you know, print work or maybe your online business, maybe you're looking to use it for a banner or who knows, maybe the back of a jacket or something like that, then this logo needs to be blown up extremely big. Chances are you're going to have to change the dimensions on it because you see all of these templates that you typically see in Canva, they're already, you know, they already have pixels that are set for that particular design. So these business logos, they tend to have pixels of 500 by 500. If you try to take this design right here and blow it up to something bigger, then it's probably going to look blurry or extremely poor quality. Just wanted to put that out there that, you know, if you're looking to do anything other than just your basic print work, then you may want to change the dimensions to this and have it a lot bigger than what it is. And also too, for this design, because it's something that's simple and easy, I'm just going to use the Canva font for this and still make it look extremely great. But just to let you know that Canva has awesome font over here. You can pretty much just use, you know, any type of font that they have on this platform. All right, so let's first look at some of the things that we can customize. And one of them is what I'm hovering over right now, which are these letters. So I think that I want to change these letters, and you can change these letters to your initials or whatever it is that you want to do, but I'm going to change them to KT. And also another thing that I'm going to want to do is I'm going to want to change the color. So if you already have your brand colors set up or you know which colors that you want to use, you can definitely do that. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this. I think I'm just going to make it something simple like black. And so I'm just go over here in the corner, put that in black, and then I'm going to change this right here. And I think I'll make that black as well, just to keep everything simple. And now we have this in black. The next thing that we can do is we can customize the information that's right here. You can put whatever you want in this particular logo. So I think what I'm going to do is I want to change this to my blog name. Now you can change it to your name. You can put a saying here or your website here, but I'm going to put my blog name there. And so I'm just going to go ahead and I'm just going to type it in right here. and put it there so that you can see exactly what it is. And then that's blog. So I went ahead and put mailbox money blog because it's going to be mailboxmoneyblog.com. I'm not going to put the .com there. I'm just going to leave this as is right here. But I think that looks pretty good right there. Now, another thing that you can do to customize this is you can change the background. I'm going to keep the background like this for right now, which is this cream color. And I'm going to show you another background in just a second. Another thing that Canva has that's really, really awesome is they have a ton of elements that you can use. I mean, they have shapes, different stickers and things like that. So I'm going to show you exactly where you can get that type of stuff. If you go over here to where it says elements, you can scroll down and you will see that they have all type of graphics. So you've got lines and shapes. You can use different frames on here. You can use different grids. So I like to use these right here, which are lines and shapes. And you can just get a ton of different, you know, objects and stuff like that. I'm going to use something simple, which is this circle right here. And it's free. If you, as you can see, it says free. So you can go ahead and click on that. Now, this is my brand color, one of my brand colors already. It just automatically populated. But this circle right here, you can use obviously any shape, but I want to use something that already mimics this circle effect that I have here. You can do something like place this circle in the center, and I prefer it to look like this. I mean, obviously you can blow it up and make it even bigger. You know, if you did so, you'd have to blow it up and you can make it bigger than what it is. But I'm just going to try this out right now. If you want to leave it just like this, then this is cool. It's pretty simple and it's plain. So I think I want to do just a little bit more to it. So you can move this thing all around if you want. And so I am going to actually make this a little bit bigger. I think I want to make it just as big as the circle itself. And by it being just as big as the circle itself, I'm going to move it over a little bit. And I'm going to move this over here a little bit. So I'm going to move that over to the right. I'm going to move this over a little bit more. And I want it to be right there in the center. I want this logo to move over. I am going to actually duplicate this. And that's really easy to do. You can just go ahead and make a duplication of it. Copy and paste. And I'm going to change the color to this, which is black. I am going to actually put it behind the pink circle. The way that you move things around is you can just position it behind the pink circle. I'm just going to make it a tad bit bigger than the pink circle. And I'm going to go up here to the right where it says position. I'm going to put it backwards. And this is how you will see it, just like this. And by it being backwards or in the back of the pink circle, now I can actually even make it even bigger and move it around. So you can actually choose to kind of like move this thing around some if you want. I'm going to move this down a little bit, which is the top circle. I am going to move this black circle right here. I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. And then I'm going to take the pink circle and put behind it. I think that might be pretty neat. So let's see, I'm going to make that one. And I think I'll make this one a little bit smaller. I'm going to make this pink circle a little bit bigger. Just add a little bit of an angle. And this just gives like a little bit of, you know, just a little bit of design. And you can literally keep your logo like this. You can see just a little bit of this over here. You can make some things a little bit bigger. And then position it and move it all around. So I'm going to now move this over. I'm going to move this over. And I think I'm going to move this over a little bit to the right, which is the black circle. And then I'm going to move the pink circle right next to it. And you can actually make this a little bit bigger, the pink circle. And then I am going to, I like it like that better. And then I'm going to move this over here and I'm going to make the initials a little bit bigger. Now, the great thing about this is you can, like I said, you can change colors. So I think I'm going to change this K to black just to make it stand out and pop a little bit more. This can literally be just like a custom logo, just the way it is right here. I think this is actually cute itself. This would really just work for a simple logo that you can just modify. You can use in any type of design that you want. So now, of course, if I was going to, you know, make another type of design, I think I would just go ahead and duplicate this. And what I can do is, if I duplicate it, I can go ahead and actually get rid of the black one. And then I can actually just make this a little bit smaller. And you can just play around with this a little bit more. I'm going to move this up. And you can make it look a little bit like this. And this is just as neat and just as cute. You know, so we're looking at just a logo that looks like that. I'm going to move this over because I don't think it's centered very well. You can take it and move this over. Now I have to move everything over and put this right here. And now you have this design like that. And so if you want to play around with your brand colors, you can definitely do that just to see what looks good and what doesn't. I mean, I can go over here, I can do that, or I can just go ahead and turn this that color. Or what I can do is I can even go back up here. Okay, so what you have now is this, and you know, if I wanted to change the color to the background, I can definitely do that. I can change it to any type of, you know, brand color that I have. And I like this color right here. So this color is a blue, which is actually a different color than the other brand color that I have, but this pops out really, really well. So if I wanted to just play around with these things and modify them, that would be really easy to do. If you want this to be transparent and you don't want to use the background and you plan on just using the logo, then all you have to do is download it as a transparent background. All you have to do is go up here where the arrow is, click on it, and I always like to download in PNG. Now you have to do is click transparent background, and once you click that, then you just go ahead and you hit download, and you can download it from there. And look what it gives you as well. I mean, if you decided to use your logo in any type of design, I mean, obviously you can go through Canva to get designs, but this is how the background would look if I decided to just use my logo in any type of print, or if I decided to even just use it online, I would be able to use it like this. All right, so we can open this up and end up looking at it. And actually, what happens here is I actually created these to see exactly how these will go. And this is what it came out to be. So these are kind of like the logos right here as well. This is what I chose to use. And I just wanted to try these things out to make sure that, hey, I was gonna have like the best simple and easy logo for you guys. That is it right there. These are the logos that I have already. And hopefully that you find this really interesting. And like I said, these are simple and easy designs that you can do. It could take you every bit of just 5 minutes to do it. All right, guys, if you want to remove the background for it, instead of using this transparent background, I've got another video that you can check out that shows you how to remove the background, especially if you're still using Canva's paid version. Because if you're using Canva's paid version, then you can't use the remove background feature. So you can try that out as well. I've got a video on that. Go check that out. That'll show you exactly how you can get this thing in a transparent background and make it extremely nice. So guys, if you don't have a logo yet, then I encourage you to try one of Canva's templates like this one right here. It's really easy and simple to create. Make sure that you hit that bell notification down below so that you're going to get more videos just like this. And also let me know down in the comment section below if this template worked for you and if you like it. All right, guys. Well, thanks for watching this video. Make sure that you come back for more tutorials just like this. And bye for now.